Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, brothers and sisters. Just wanted to share a couple of points with regards to coronavirus. Number one, alhamdulillah, the masjid is taking some real steps, alhamdulillah, and there's going to be a communication that's going to be sent out later tonight or maybe early tomorrow morning, inshallah, with regards to that. So, alhamdulillah, I just wanted to put everybody's mind at rest that at the masjid, alhamdulillah, they're trying to stay on top of it, inshallah. Now, from our perspective, how do we deal with this? Right, very important. So, first of all, making sure that our iman and our yaqeen stays very strong, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you say, tell the people, لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا, that only that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for us will touch us, will happen to us. Huwa Mawlana, he is our protector, our friend, and our Lord. Wa ala Allahi falyatawakkalul mu'minun, and it is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the believers should place their trust. So having complete trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having complete conviction that yes, we live in a world of means, yes, there is cause and effect, and yes, all of these things are in place, right? But at the end of the day, nothing happens to us unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills it. So having that very, if anything, this should bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This should make us spend more time in dua in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This should be making us increase in our khushu within our salah, right? So bringing us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Use this as an excuse to bring yourself close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's number one, having complete trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the same time, we do live in a world of cause and effect. We live in Darul Asbab, right? Cause and effect, a world of cause and effect. So we take all necessary precautions, right? So one extreme is people say that, you know what, we have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I don't need to take any precautions. That's very wrong, right? On the other hand, people say, you know what, I will take all the precautions that I can and it is only the precautions that are going to save me. That is very wrong. As Muslims, we take all precautions, we do whatever is within our capability, and we have the support of the trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do what is best for us, inshallah. So the precautions, what should we do, right? When we're coming to the masjid, specifically speaking about coming to the masjid, make sure that we try to make wudu before we come to the masjid, right? If you're coming from home, make wudu before you come to the masjid. That's where the real reward is. Right, the real reward in the hadith, when it speaks about the reward of walking to the masjid and so on and so forth, it talks about making wudu at home. Right, so the reward, that's what we're being told. The real reward is when you make wudu at home, anyways. So try to make wudu at home if you can, inshallah, just so that there's less contamination on the taps and so on and so forth, and there's not so many people touching them and so on. If you have to make wudu here, alhamdulillah, no problem, right? But try to make it at home if you can, right? When we get here, make sure that we have a habit. I mean, wudu is a beautiful habit. We know that within our deen, subhanAllah, at-tuhuru shatrul iman, purity is half of our iman, right? So having this continuous habit of washing our hands and so on and so forth. When you wash your hands, make sure that you wash with soap if you can, at least 20 seconds. This is when it's most effective, right? So washing our hands before we come for salah, after we finish salah, and even when we're meeting one another, you know, a simple salam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, you know, if you want, you put your hand over your heart just to show that you're feeling, but the shaking of the hands and the hugging and so on and so forth, at this point, we try to leave it out. It's not something that we necessarily have to do. So when the situation is as we know it, as it is right now, then we try to stay away from shaking one another's hands and so on and so forth, just for safety's sake, right? So not shaking hands and not hugging and so on and so forth. And then when we're talking about coming for Jumu'ah specifically, right, that we try to make it so that if Jumu'ah is not fard upon us, right, so the men should be coming for Jumu'ah, right? If it's fard upon you, then you come for Jumu'ah. If it's not fard upon you, for our women folk, for the ladies, for the children, right, and the infirm and so on and so forth, right, that is a time when, you know what, if it's not something that you have to come to, if it's not fard upon you, then leave it out for now, right? So that's another thing. If you're coming for salah, right, consider bringing a prayer mat, consider bringing a musalla, a sajada, right, so that you're not making sajda in the same place that the others are making sajda. Maybe someone coughs, it remains on the carpet and so on and so forth. So just saying safe, inshallah. And then if you do by chance you sneeze or you cough while you are around others, the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is that he would cover his face. He was cover his face. So again, sneezing in the arm and so on and so forth, this is a good practice. It's also a sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, right? And finally is if you feel that you're sick, you have a cough, you have a sore throat, or you're feeling a fever coming on and so on and so forth, then we shouldn't be coming to the masjid, right? Always keep the safety of the jama'ah before our own wants and our own needs, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect everyone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this pass with ease, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it pass quickly, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us, our families, Canada, people of Canada, people of the world, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this pass as easy and as quickly as possible. Just quickly before you, a dua that we can think of. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-baras wal-junun wal-judham wa sayyi al-asqam. Right? Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-baras wal-junun wal-judham wa sayyi al-asqam. This is dua when you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save you from many different types of sicknesses, right? Another dua, three times in the morning, three times in the evening. Bismillahi alladhi la yadurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama wa huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. Bismillahi alladhi la yadurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama wa huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. Three times, right? Morning and evening. And this is, our Prophet has told us that if you can read this in the morning and you have proper yaqeen in it, you have proper conviction in it, then nothing will harm you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all tawfiq. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.